So I've been making a lot of wearable tech recently. Continuing with that trend, today's project, wearable heads-up display. Because you know, robots are gonna take over the world anyway, so might as well, handbrake turn into that curve. So it seems like the biggest problem with wearable tech in general is making it look good. So I think with this video, if we can figure out a way to make smart glasses look cool, that's a successful video right there. Honestly, just chuck an Apple logo on there, people will think it's cool. Some of that AirPod magic, that's what we need.
Fellow pods.
Good times, bro.
So I've got some idea of how to do this. I'm not entirely sure if you guys are gonna think it's as clever as I do. If you think this is actually like a serious video, then you probably won't like it. Yeah, I'm gonna take a very creative approach to this problem. That's all I'm gonna say. Just watch.
Stopwatch 6, 7, voice crack 7, 7. It's kind of cool.
So hopefully you guys followed all that. Full disclosure, I changed this project like 6 times while making it. I was originally gonna use like a projector to project onto the lens of the glasses, and you could also have it project like through the lens onto a wall so everyone could see it, which is a really cool idea actually. Shame I did this. We'll get it next time. For now, here's what I did. Yeah, this thing. A lot of you have noticed that my recent videos have been pretty hacked together. And that's because I'm studying abroad right now, and I don't really have access to the proper materials and resources. So think of these videos as like proofs of concept. Obviously I can make it a lot better with like 3D printing and actual planning and intelligence. Don't take it too seriously, just keep an open mind. So this is how it works. In this little box right here, we have a cheap display, a servo, and a lens so you can actually see the display. You turn it on, there's a little button on the side. It'll pop up and the display will turn on. You just slip these glasses on just like normal everyday glasses, and in there you can see right now I think we're on a stopwatch. So inside here we have a bunch of different apps preloaded. So right now it's giving us a clock right now. We've got the weather on there too. And we've got all your messages and calls on there as well. So the glasses are powered by an Arduino Nano, along with a tiny little lithium ion battery all housed in here. Also got a Bluetooth module in here, which I'm still figuring out how to use correctly, so you can pull notifications right from your phone. Try and leave relevant links down in the description. So you put it on your head like this. Whenever you have a notification, it'll flip down. just like that. You can read your notifications, and then when you're done reading, so you can see normally, it just pops back up. So just being realistic for a second, you could actually use the thing for a bunch of projects if you need to be using your hands and also look at information. If you ever wanted to make sort of like an Iron Man heads-up display, this could be a good way to do it. So yeah, it's got a ton of other practical uses, and we'll cover that in later videos, but that's not the point of this one. I bet by now you are wondering, what the hell is up with this bandana dangling off the glasses? It's called style. So yeah, I can't show you calls, text, weather, all stuff like that. But here's the thing, guys. Millennials, they don't want any of that stuff. Weather, calendar, calls, text. No, that's way too useful. See, you gotta think like this generation. That's where Google went wrong. Really just put yourself into a millennial's mind.
What's that? Sorry, I was taking a selfie while shooting a Snapchat while periscoping that Snapchat.
So, as you may know, it's festival season. Summer's coming up, festivals popping up everywhere, Coachella's happening. So I have tailored this device.
Ugh, dragonfly.
So I have tailored this device specifically for those festival goers. This is what smart glasses should really be about. Festival gods have done well. So I just want to take a minute to really appreciate the geniusness of this invention. Like, I don't think you can comprehend the level of sophistication that is this. Like, we got all the stops. Flowery shirt, colored pants, you see that sweet kick. Hipster glasses without the lens. That's 20 more festival points. And to top it off, we built the whole thing into a bandana. That, wait for it, folds up. He's genius. You can just dance all you want, and then it comes down, it pops right down when you got a notification. I can see right now what the time is. I can check my calls, texts, pops back up when you don't have any notifications. Keep on dancing. Oh, pops back down. Maybe someone's trying to call you, pops back down again. And it's over, pops right back up, keep on going. Too white for this. Now, but as I said, we don't want any of that boring information. This is what festival goers want.
You have $50 left to spend.
Hi, can I get one drink, please? Thank you very much.
You have $1 left to spend.
Yeah, that's about right.
Free food to your right.
Hell yeah.
Nickel back to your right.
I threw a standing in line.
Avril Lavigne to your right.
Not for me, bruh.
You have gone 32 hours without food, water, or sleep. Tickets for next year are now available.
That about wraps it up for this video. Hopefully you did enjoy it. Hopefully, you know, don't take it too seriously, obviously. But like a lot of my recent videos, yeah, I am joking. Like, I don't actually think this should ever be a thing. But kind of the underlying theme, if you will, is that people don't want to have wearable tech because it's not cool. If you can actually make something that is cool and starts to trend, that is the real secret right there. Like, you'd be friends with a guy who looks like this, right? Jesus Christ, I look like an insane person. What else? Comment what you want me to do next down below. Maybe those projector glasses that I talked about earlier. Go follow me on Instagram too. Check out Avril Lavigne. Like and subscribe, all that. Wait, Old Town Road, stage 4, right now? All right, I'm on it.
The horses in the bag.
This is why we need this.
Head is mad at black, got the boosters black to match.
Get him.